Pastor Clark.
Thank you.
I
Okay, this is the baby. We should add this in the, before putting it in the microwave. Quite before they still, I think this is the right place to put it in the microwave.
The Seventh Commandment.
Yeah, that broke, start here. And we stop here. There.
We stop right here, Jesus is not orphan. Jesus is not orphan.
The original Edenic law, on there.
The most excellent, Bishop Mason, how was that?
He can't say that.
He got caught, maybe somebody saw it.
Yeah. Getting back.
I should make the way, but I can't see it.
Yeah, don't let it know. Look out of here.
Seven of seven.
Praise him. How you doing, brother? Good. All right, we're gonna have prayer. Precious God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you, dear God, for allowing us together one more time. We thank you, dear God, for taking us through the day. We thank you for mine to serve you in your last and evil days. Oh God, look on the sin of a Bible study. Open our understanding to your word. God, give us a mind to look to you as never before. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
The brother don't have one. You have
yes,
a copy.
The same copy.
Oh, good.
Evangelist Jordan making a copy for us.
Huh?
Evangelist Jordan making a copy.
Oh, okay, good. Evangelist, you know where we stopped at before, right? Today's of what?
Four.
Who is waiting for the message?
Evangelist, she had mine. She had to make a copy for her.
Okay. So we're starting what's the reading?
Jesus did not alter the original Edenic law in that much. You should back up to this commandment.
What happened? You made it?
Yeah, I made it. Got to make it.
You didn't make the one?
Yeah, I made one, but I have to make another copy. I forgot about it very soon.
Make another copy too.
You want two?
Yeah.
Two copies of it.
So everybody just about have a sheet. So we can go ahead and start discussing. You can start reading this.
Where you want to start here?
Yeah. Back up, sir.
Okay. So this commandment. Mm-hmm.
Let them know where you're reading
from. I'm going to start from this commandment affirms. Okay? All right. This commandment affirms the sanctity of sex. God created it, God protected it, and God punishes when his law is violated. 9 of the 10 commandments are repeated in the New Testament for us to heed. The Sabbath commandment was given only to Israel and does not apply to the church today. We must not think that because we are under grace, we can flaunt God's law and get away with it. Fornicators and adulterers, God will judge. Hebrews 13:4. However, Jesus went much deeper in his discussion of adultery. He showed that this can be a sin of the heart as well as a sin of the body.
Let's look at that. Let's look at that a little bit. Now, you see that the first beginning that you're reading, what did it say?
That the commandment affirms the sanctity of sex. God created it, God protected it, protects it, and God punishes when his law is violated.
So when God gives a commandment like that, or his word, we are supposed to heed the word of God at all times. It don't have to satisfy us, but we have to do it because God said so. And many times we think that it should please us in order that God might be satisfied. But it's not so. We are to heed the word of God. And that's why people are running into so much problem today, because they're refusing to heed the word of God. See, people think that they can do anything and get by with it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You can't do it. You got to go by the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
If the word of God says this, he mean that.
Yes, mm-hmm.
He don't mean detour and if you ain't got nothing else to do, you can do it. No, that's not the case. And we look at it so different and so wrong.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And people understand the same way with God's word, same with the world.
That's right.
Just a consequence.
Right.
Mm-hmm. For every action, there's a reaction.
They have signs out there in the street, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cross on the green.
Right.
Not on the red.
Mm-hmm.
Look how many people get killed.
Yeah.
Just walking on the red.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. Going against the law,
that's right.
And get hurt. Oh, they also, yeah, they also,
you know, when they were in the wrong,
yeah,
yeah, and that law is on the books, as far as the law of the city, mm-hmm. You know, is the law. It's called jaywalking.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
You know, and we get away with it.
Yeah,
some states hit you with it.
That's right.
They give you a ticket right there for jaywalking.
Yeah, but, well, they used to do it one time here.
Yeah,
years ago they did.
Yeah.
Every now and then, they will give it a take.
Yeah.
But now
it's a consequence for everything.
You do. They have red lights on Queens Boulevard.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody getting killed is getting knocked down over there every day, just about.
Because they don't take heed to
follow clear instructions.
Do what they want to do.
Yeah, they don't.
And see, this is, if we want blessings from God, mm-hmm. we have to always learn how to heed the word of God. Mm-hmm. And if we don't heed the word of God, we're not going to get the blessings of God. Mm-hmm. It's just that simple. We go through motions, and that's mm-hmm. all it is. Motions.
That's what,
as far as getting the blessings of God, we cannot do it. Mm-hmm. What did I love reading there about adultery?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. However, Jesus went much deeper in his discussion of adultery.
Uh-huh.
He showed that this can be a sin of the heart as well as a sin of the body.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Let's look at that. Adultery.
Mm-hmm.
He said it can be of the heart
yeah.
as well as the body.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can think on it.
Think on it.
You can think on it. You ain't got to actually commit it. Just thinking on it.
Yeah.
It's a sin. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, he said the Bible said if you look at a woman and love them. And they go for not only women now.
Yeah.
That go for men too.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. Men and women. If you lust after. But now we can cause one another to lust and do
sin.
Can.
Mm-hmm. We can. We sure
you see, can. And many times people don't realize that they can cause a problem yeah. themselves. Why do you think so many women, they got a husband and they still cause their husband to go out and commit adultery, cause them to do the same thing?
Yeah.
Same thing with the man, mm-hmm. cause the wife to do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And the Bible give you, tell you exactly yeah. what you ought to do. Then not to run into these kind of problems.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We ignore those things. Mm-hmm. And when you ignore these things in the Bible, you think you're going to get away with it? No.
It's consequences.
Anything that we do contrary to the word of God is a consequence.
It's a consequence and a sin.
Why would you want to pay later on something that you could correct? Something that you don't have to do. It's just like telling a lie. You know a lie is a lie. Why? Before you tell it.
That's right.
And then you don't have to worry about begging nobody's pardon or going to God asking
that's
God
right.
to forgive you.
Or trying to live that life.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Lie after lie after lie after lie.
Mm-hmm. Count up the cost before.
See, I look at these things. It's the church folks that have the biggest problems in life.
Mm-hmm.
It's the unsaved people, they don't seem to be going through that kind of a problem. It's only the church folks, that the ones that's supposed to know the right thing and don't do it.
I don't know the order. You probably got to put it in the order.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the order. They print it out. I don't know what page is first, second.
All right, let's try to find it.